Welcome to Backbench Classroom. How it works? Today, we are discussing about the production of induced EMF. The production of induced EMF is basically depends upon the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So, Faraday's first law of electromagnetic induction states that whenever the magnetic field flux is cut by any current carrying conductor, an EMF is going to be induced in this particular conductor. And the second law states that the magnitude of induced EMF across that particular conductor is directly proportional to the rate of change of flux linkage. So here on we can say that if induced EMF is E, then E proportional to number of turn of that conductor into d phi by dt. Then the lenses came into account. Lenz states that the direction of the induced EMF is such that the current produced by it sets up a magnetic field opposing the motion or change of producing it. So, E become is equal to minus N into d phi by dt. This entire thing is explained here that the initial flux before cut by the conductor is phi 1 and initial time is t 1. And after cutting the flux, the final flux is phi 2 and the final time is t 2, then induced EMF should be proportional to phi 2 minus phi 1 divided by t 2 minus t 1. So, this one is equal to E proportional to d phi by dt, where d phi is the rate of change of flux is equal to phi 2 minus phi 1. And dt is the time required for change of flux, that means t2 minus t1. And as we already discussed, the induced EMF should be the number of turn into the rate of change of flux. So here the number of turn E is equal to n into d phi by dt, where n is the number of turns. And from Lenz's law, the induced EMF should be E is equal to minus N d phi by dt. So, this is the EMF equation we can derive from Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Thank you for watching Backbench Classroom. Please like, share and comment. And don't forget to subscribe Backbench Classroom.